In this example, we're going to create a generic class called a box that's going to hold a single object inside of it. Now, before we go on, in this package, you'll also see that there's a cat class, very similar to what we saw when we did the inheritance examples earlier in the semester. This cat is here just so we can put it in the box later. I think, though, this class shouldn't be confusing to you. It should be pretty simple. So for our actual box, it's going to be a generic class, and you can tell because we have this generic type here. So anytime we use T inside this class, it's going to refer to whatever type we instantiate the box with. So the box is going to have one item in it. So we'll do a default constructor, which will just create an empty box. And then we'll create another constructor that will take an item. We'll call the super constructor, and then we'll set our item to whatever item was passed in. And we probably should have let Eclipse create that constructor for us, because I'm pretty sure that's identical to what it would have done. So we'll let you add something to the box. And again, we don't know what type it is, so we'll just use T. And then we'll say that item equals T. Here, one thing to keep in mind is that when we add something to the box, whatever was in the box just disappears. So I guess in that way, it's sort of a magical box of some sort. But we would want to be careful. We're not saying, hey, there's something in there. Are you sure you want to add it? We're just saying, hey, look, if you add something to the box, whatever's in there just disappears. So we'll have a getter, but instead of calling it get item, we'll call it what's in the box, and that will return the item. I guess we're not really telling. It sort of jumps out at you, I guess, maybe. I don't know. Anyway, no, we don't have to call the getter get whatever the variable name is. We can just write a function that describes what you're doing if you want to get that variable. And in this case, you're asking what's in the box. And then we'll add a toString method, or more correctly, we'll let Eclipse make a toString method for us. And that will complete our box class. Our box class is going to contain a single item, and then we can add something to the box, making what was there before disappear. We can ask what's in the box, and then we can print what's in the box. So now, let's see what this box can do. So I'm going to make four different boxes. So box one will be a string box. Box two, and that should be new, will be an integer box. Box three will be a cat box. And for now, it's an empty box, right? Because I didn't add any arguments to the constructor, so it'll use that default constructor, which sets that item reference to null. So first, we need to add a cat to the box. Actually, how does it know what item is? Is that public? It should be. So I'm not sure how it did that, but I'm going to change that either way. So box three, we're going to add a new cat, Schrodinger, and then let's print the three boxes, and then I'll change these so that they reflect the right number. So let's run our code. Oops, we have some bugs. Oh, we don't have box four yet. I guess that'll be what we'll do. We'll run this, and then we'll add do box four, because you can see it prints what's there. Remember, our box can only hold one item, but that's not really true, because I can say that my box is going to hold an array list of objects. Now, this is going to get really crazy, because what can an object reference refer to? Well, it can refer to anything, and that should just be object. So now we have this array list of object, and you can see that it wants us to import it. So let's do that. What my box has is an array list, so I can use that box and add things to that array list. So I'm going to, and I'll do this up here just so it doesn't mess up with the box stuff. So I'm going to make an array list of objects. I'll call it stuff. Notice the difference here. Here I'm making a new array list. Here I'm making a new box that holds an array list. So then to add things to this array list, we'll add one. We'll add burrow, which is a string. We'll add a character. And while we're at it, let's add a cat. Now, the only reason we're not adding dogs as well is because we have the cat class here. That's sufficient to demonstrate that we can add any type of class that we create ourselves. So nothing particularly against cats here. To really go crazy, I'm also going to add box one to the array list. And then here, I'm going to say box four, I'm going to add stuff. So now, let's run this. We'll uncomment where we're going to print that out before. And then now you can see there's our stuff. Notice it prints all of these out because they all implement toString, including the box. Notice here, it prints out the same thing that's in box one. So why use generic types? Well, box one, if you'll remember, holds strings. Box two does integers. So I'm going to add four to box one, and I'm going to add test to box two. And you'll notice that I have two error messages saying that the method addInteger for the type box is not valid for argument string. And I'll get a similar one here saying the method addString to type box of string is not applicable for the int arguments. So I can't do this. The compiler protects me. But I can add additional things to the boxes. And I guess the question is, we've already established that I can add something new. And let's go ahead and print everything out again after we've added something new to each of the boxes. So when I run this, you'll notice all of these change. Basically, these items that were in the boxes before, those are gone. We don't have a reference to them. We've replaced those. And of course, the ArrayList one is the same. Well, the ArrayList is not quite the same because we do have box one in there. And so since it's changed, we get a little bit of a difference. So the question is, I hope you can see, we could just create a new ArrayList and say, well, I'm going to put a new ArrayList in there. But what if I want to add to this ArrayList? Well, it turns out we can do that. We can say, and we'll call this a temp list, and that's going to be box four, what's in the box. Then if I say temp list, add, and I'll add a seven, and I'll add a CSC205 string there. Now when I run this, you'll actually see those items have been added to the list because that array list is in there. But when I get this reference to that using what's in the box, which returns a reference to the item in the box, now, since I know that that's going to be an array list of objects, that'll work. To be clear, this wouldn't work if I'd said box three, because that's going to return a cat, because we put cats in box three. So this object reference has to be an array list of objects in order to work. So that's a quick introduction to generic classes in Java. It should be a little more involved than the previous one we did, and hopefully this is all starting to make sense. But again, we're going to be using generic types throughout the semester. So if it's not clear now, or we have examples that won't be quite as arbitrary as just, hey, this is just a box class. And the next module will cover lists, where we'll have a generic list class that will hold any type of object in that list.